You're looking at the candidates who want your vote. It's fast approaching general election time, and candidates across the three constituencies in our city will be stepping up their efforts to win support ahead of May. 2010 saw history as the Green Party gained its first MP in Brighton Pavilion as Caroline Lucas was elected. It was also the first time since 1997 where Labour lost their hold of Hove. And this year it could be yet another game changer, with UKIP set to make their mark across the city. The constituency of Hove is usually a good indicator as to who will get their hands on number 10. But with recent opinion polls showing that none of the main parties have an overall majority, how do voters here feel that things will turn out in May?
I think it's impossible for anybody to say in a multi-party situation, which is a relatively new phenomenon, the votes are going to be splintered. Yes, it could be the Conservatives, it could be Labour. Don't think it'll be the Greens. It certainly won't be UKIP.
I think it's going to be very close. I think it's going to be very close at the general election overall. I don't think any of the parties have got a particularly clear mandate. I'd be very worried if Labour got in, because I think the Conservatives have done a very good job about trying to pay down the deficit. And I trust them more.
I think it's always been Conservative. I think there are a lot of older voters, and although I'm an older voter myself, people tend to stick with the party that they've always voted for.
In just over 100 days, residents across the city will make their minds up at the polling booths for not only the national but local elections. The result could see drastic changes to the political spectrum for those running our country, constituency and city. May the 7th will certainly be interesting. This is James Dunham for Latest TV News.